go. This is from 7B of the orientation session 2, taking the antiderivative of, antiderivatives that give you the inverse sine, inverse cosine, and inverse tan functions. Okay, so looking at this, when I've got 1 on top of the square root of a squared minus x, it's an inverse sine. Negative 1 on top of the square root of a squared minus x, it's a positive inverse cosine, and a over a squared plus x squared. Okay, so here I've got 1 on top of the square root, so positive 1, so I'm looking at this particular answer. 9 will be 3 squared, so this is the same as the integral of 1 on top of the square root of 3 squared minus x squared dx, which is going to be this rule here, so it's going to equal the inverse sine of x on 3 plus some constant c. It says the following integrals, therefore it's the, I need the general rule, so I need to add c. Looking at the second one, it's about t and that's dt. I've got this over this, so I'm looking at this particular rule here because I don't have a square root on the bottom. So I've got the integral of 1 on top of 3 squared plus 4t squared dt, because a squared will be 9, therefore a is 3. I need a 3 on the top. I need a 3 there because I need a at the top. Therefore, I'm going to counterbalance that with a third out the front. These 3s would cancel to leave me exactly a 1 on top. Okay, so it's going to equal 1 third inverse tan. X is 4t on top of a, which is 3, plus some constant c. And lastly, I've got a positive 1, so I've got this one again. However, what do I have? I need to take that 2 out as a common factor. So I'm going to consider this as being the integral of 1 on top of the square root of 2 outside of 5 on 2 minus x squared dx. Okay, so I can write this as being, I might do this right over here, 1 on top of root 2 square root of 5 on 2 minus x squared dx. Okay, so I've got a 1 on root 2 outside of here, and I've got a square root of 5 on 2 minus x squared. If I'm looking at this, I've got to have a squared there, which means a squared in this particular case will be root 5 on root 2. So a squared is root 5 on root 2. Sorry, 5 on 2. A squared equals 5 on 2. A equals root 5 on root 2. So this is going to equal 1 on root 2 inverse sine. X is x on top of root 5 on root 2 plus some constant c, which is going to equal root 2 on 2 inverse sine of root 2x on root 5 plus some constant c. Let's just double check and see if that's correct. So I've entered it into the calculator here. Math 2 integral with respect to x. Okay, there's my root 2 on 2 inverse sine. All right, they've rationalized the denominator there. So that would become the same as 5 on the bottom multiplied top, so root 10x inverse sine root 2 on 2 plus some constant c. And that's the same answer.